Hello students, welcome to the online classes of social studies. Let's continue chapter 1 of geography, the earth and the solar system. In the previous class we had learnt about the sun and the stars, the universe, nebula, stars and constellation. Today we shall learn about galaxy, planets, sun, solar system and so on. Let's continue. Galaxy, many constellations, the sun and all the stars that you see at night form one galaxy. So what is galaxy? Galaxy consists of many constellations. I told you constellation is when some stars form a pattern. So when we have many constellations, the sun and all the stars that we see in the night, they form one galaxy. You can notice on a clear starry night that there is a stretch on the sky which has comparatively more number of stars than the rest of the sky. So sometimes at night when you look at the sky, you will see that our sky, one side maybe it is full of stars and sometimes it's not so much full of the stars. There are millions of stars in this patch. So somewhere you will see in the sky there are plenty of stars, somewhere you will find less stars. This belt of star is called a galaxy known as the Milky Way. So this belt where we can see lots and lots of star, that is a galaxy named as Milky Way. In Hindi, this galaxy is also known as Akash Ganga. There are many such galaxies in the universe. So there are lots of galaxies in the universe and a galaxy consists of many constellations and stars, sun. So there are many galaxies in the universe. Our Earth belongs to Milky Way galaxy. Milky Way galaxy is called in Hindi as Akash Ganga. Planets. These are celestial bodies which are solid in nature and revolve around a star. So planets are also heavenly bodies and they are solid in nature and they revolve around the stars, like all the eight planets are revolving around the star which is named as Sun. They have a fixed path called orbit and all the planets have a fixed path to move around and the path they follow is called as orbit, which is not absolutely circular but elongated or ellipticated. So the path of all the planet is not circular, not in circle shape around the sun, but it is little oval, elliptical or elongated. There may be many other bodies but they are not categorized as planets as they may be too small or have erratic planets orbits or paths. Erratic orbits and paths. So maybe there are lots of other objects in the galaxy or in the universe, but we don't tell them all as as planets. Why? Because they may be too small or do not have a fixed path to follow. We call a planet only on the basis of they should have a preferable size and should have a orbit and path to follow around the sun. So there are many, but they all are not called as planets because they are not having a huge size and they do not follow a particular orbit or path. In the same way, we had Pluto also as a planet, which is no more in the category of a planet now, as it is not having it's too small and not following the orbit or the path. Planets are of many sizes. They do not have their own light and heat, but reflect the light of the star they revolve around. So all the planets are of not same size. some are quite big, some are small, they vary in sizes. And the light and heat on all the planet comes from the sun. We can say from the stars. So stars have their own heat and light, but the planets do not have heat and light. They get heat and light from the stars, sun. Okay? The sun. The sun is the closest star to the earth and it is a huge ball of burning gases. It has a diameter of about 1300,000 kilometers or nearly 100 times that of the earth. So, sun is also a star and it is very close to the earth. That's why it looks quite big compared to the other stars. And it is made up of different gases. So we call it a huge ball of burning gases. The diameter of sun is 1300,000 kilometers, or we can see nearly 100 times that of the earth. By volume, it is about 10 lakh times larger than the earth. And it is estimated that the temperature on the sun's surface is about 6000 degrees Celsius. So it is estimated that maybe or the sun has at least the temperature 6000 degrees Celsius. We can imagine how hot it is. When we have 45-50 degree temperature, we feel so uncomfortable. So imagine 6000 degrees Celsius is the temperature on the earth's sun's surface. You can imagine how hot it would be if you consider that the oven in which a cake is baked is at about 300 degrees Celsius and water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. So we can imagine how hot the surface of the sun is. There we can compare that 300 degrees Celsius is only in the oven when you are baking a cake, or it is 100 degrees Celsius when we boil the water. So 6000 degree, how hot it would be. In this emits, it thus emits a lot of heat and light in all direction. So sun gives out lot of heat and light in all around it. It has a gravitational pull which keeps the planets from moving too far away from its orbit. So it has also a gravitational pull which doesn't allow the planets to move away far away from the orbits. It is about 150 million kilometers away from the Earth. So distance of the Earth and the Sun is 150 million kilometers. Importance of the Sun in our life. How important is the Sun in my and in your life? It is the biggest source of heat and light on the Earth, and without these, the light would or the earth would have been too cold to sustain life. So we can imagine if there is no sun, there will be no heat and no light, and it will be too cold to have life. No life will be possible if there is no sun. The heat and light from the sun is essential for the plants to make their own food. If there will be no sun, the plants need the light of the sun to make their food. If there will be no sun, there will be no plants, no trees. So if there are no plants and trees, there will be no life. The sun is important as it is in changing season on the earth. The sun also helps in changing of the seasons. If there is no sun, we will not have different seasons. We will be having only one season throughout the year. The sun causes water and air circulations or currents which cause movement and weather. So sun is also causing water and air currents. In the water also there are currents, movement of water, and in the air also there is movement of air only because of the sun. Okay, so these are the importance of sun, that sun. Without the sun, heat and light, it would be too cold. Plants will not make their food, and there won't be seasons, and there will be no circulation, or we can say currents, in the water and air. The sun, along with its set of planets and other natural objects moving around it, are jointly referred as system called the solar system. So what is solar system? Solar system is sun, 8 planets and asteroids, meteors, comets, all this set is called as solar system. This is also commonly known as the sun and its family. So we can call it as solar system and sun and its family. The sun and the 8 planets and asteroids, meteors, comets, they are called as the solar system and the sun's family. There are 8 planets in the solar system. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. We know before there were 9 planets, but now we have 8 planets only. Now we will be learning about each planet in detail. Mercury, it is the closest planet to the sun. It does not have any satellite. It has smallest orbit. It takes only 88 days to complete one revolution around the sun. It rotates on its axis in 59 days. So the first planet which is very close to the sun is Mercury. And it has very small path to follow around the sun. And it can complete the one revolution of that path in 88 days. Like Earth takes 365 days, Mercury takes 88 days only. And it completes the circle or rotation of its axis in 59 days. Earth completes it in 24 hours. That means the Mercury is moving very slowly. That's why it takes 59 days to complete its one circle on its axis. Venus. Venus is the second planet from the sun. It is also known as the twin of the Earth, as its size is nearly identical to the Earth, as it is easily visible in the sky in the early morning and early evening. It is also known as morning or evening star. It has no satellite. It takes 255 days to complete a revolution around the sun. It rotates on its axis in 243 days. So what are the features of Venus? Venus is second, situated from the sun. And its size is nearly about the size of the Earth. That's why we can call it as also twin of the Earth, and sometimes we can see it in the early morning and in the early evening. That's why the planet is also called as morning and the evening star. It also has no moon, no satellites, like the Mercury also has no moon, no satellites, and it is completing its rotation around the sun in 255 days, and on its own axis it is completing its rotation in 243 days. Earth. We know that Earth is the third planet from the sun, but according to size it is fifth. We know that Earth takes to complete one revolution around the sun, that is 365 days and 1/4, that means 6 hours. 365 days and 6 hours it takes. But for our convenience, we only count 365 days, and those 6 hours we commute for the 4 years and it becomes 24 hours, and then we have a leap year. And Earth looks blue in color when we see it from the sky because of the presence of water. Earth has got satellite, that is moon, okay? The Earth rotates on its axis in 24 hours. Earth is not fully spherical, not a full circle. It is little flattened ball, slightly bulged on both the side, and on the top and bottom it is slightly flat. So both the side it is bulged, on the top and bottom it is little flat. That's why we can't say it is absolutely spherical in shape. This shape of little flattened and we can say flat on the top and bottom and bulged in the middle
This type of shape is called as geoid. It spins like a top and completes one rotation in 24 hours. So like a top which we play now, like lattu which you say, it is moving in that type and it is completing its one rotation on its own axis as a top moves on its own axis in 24 hours. It keeps revolving around the sun in anti-clockwise direction. Not the clockwise, anti-clockwise direction it is revolving around the sun. Unique feature of the planet is that the Earth is only planet in the solar system where life is existing, and it has water, land, air, sustainable for life as it is not too hot nor too cold, neither it is too close to the sun nor too far away. So neither it is too hot nor too cold, so life is possible here. Presence of various gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen in its atmosphere supports life on Earth. So life is a unique, Earth is a unique planet here in the solar system because there is life, there is water, there is land, air, different gases and temperature, favorable temperature, neither too hot nor too cold.
The next planet is Mars. Mars is situated on the fourth position from the sun and it looks blue in, it looks red in color. Like Earth looks blue in color, Mars looks red in color. What is the reason? The reason is that the soil on the Mars has red oxides, which makes it look red in color. To complete its one revolution around the sun, the Mars takes 687 days, and to complete one rotation on its axis, it takes one day, that is 24 hours. So this is about Mars, fourth situated from the sun, looks red in color because of the red oxide in the soil. 687 days for the revolution around the sun and 24 hours for completing one rotation on its axis. Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars are made up of rocks and are called inner planets. Why they are called inner planets? Because after these four planets, we have a belt of asteroids. Asteroids are rocks and stones which are moving around the sun. After the asteroid belt, again we have next four planets which are called as outer planets. The inner planets, which we have learnt already, Mercury, Mars, Venus and Earth, are made up of rocks. And the outer planets are very far and they are made up of liquids and gases. Jupiter. Jupiter is fifth planet from the sun and the largest planet of the solar system. So this is the largest planet, fifth situated from the sun. And it takes 11 years and 11 months to revolve around the sun. But its own rotation speed is the fastest. To move around the sun, it is very slow. It takes 11 years and 11 months. But to move around on its own axis, it takes only 9 hours, 56 minutes. That means nearly 10 hours. So the speed of rotation on its own axis is very fast, nearly 10 hours, but the speed of revolution around the sun is very slow, 11 years and 11 months. It has 16 satellites or moons around it. Like we have one moon, the Jupiter has got 16 moons. Saturn. Saturn is sixth planet from the sun and the second largest after the Jupiter. The largest is Jupiter. After that, we have second largest is Saturn. It has rings around it and this makes it one of the distinct and beautiful planet of the solar system, which can be seen through a telescope. So when you will look at the Saturn from the telescope, you will see some rings around it. It looks the beautiful planet. The rings are made up of dust, rocks and ice. So these rings which we can see in the Saturn are made up of ice, rocks and dust. It revolves around the sun in 29 years and 5 months, and on its own axis it is rotating with a very high speed of 10 hours and 40 minutes. It has over 30 satellites or moons. So the speed of revolution is very slow around the sun, that is 29 years and 5 months, and the speed of rotation on its own axis is 10 hours and 40 minutes, and it has got 30 moons, 30 satellites. Uranus, this is the seventh planet from the sun, and it is the third largest planet from the solar system. So it is situated on the seventh position from the sun, and after the Jupiter and Saturn, the Uranus is third largest in the solar system. This also has rings around it, and its orbit around the sun 84 years. So it orbits around the sun in 84 years. Revolution around the sun takes in 84 years. On its axis, it rotates only in 17 hours and 14 minutes. It has got 17 satellites or moon revolving around it. So Uranus has rings around it. It takes 84 years to revolute around the sun, and to rotate on its axis it takes 17 hours and 14 minutes. It has got 17 satellites, 17 moons. Neptune is the last planet situated from the sun and very, very far away from the sun. It is the fourth largest. So according to the size, the biggest one is Jupiter, second biggest is Saturn, third biggest is Uranus, fourth is Neptune, and fifth is Earth. So the fourth largest planet it is, and very, very far away from the sun. Last one, this appears blue, but it is not due to the presence of water, but due to the presence of methane gas. So it also looks blue in color because of the presence of the methane gas, and it revolves around the sun in 164 years and rotates around on own axis in 16 hours and 7 minutes. It has got 8 satellites and moons around it. So Neptune has got 8 satellites, 8 moons. Looks blue in color because of the methane gas present here. So students, today we have learnt about all the 8 planets and their features. Tomorrow we shall continue with the other celestial bodies and their features. Thank you.